The Ascent. Tanya set out to reach the mountain summit to meet the venerable Council of Little Snots. But the inhospitable terrain was battered by raging storms and was home to stubborn dwarves. In the mountains, Talia had completed a portion of the climb to the summit.
What, pray tell, do you mean portion of the climb? I just did my cardio training for the next 3 years. Is it just me, or do I end up climbing some peak in every damn part of this series?
Important things seem to have a penchant for hiding in remote places, and the Council of Little Snots was no exception. Tanya had to reach the mountain peak. The Council of Little Snots could be found there. She would have to gain access to it via the twisted cave system. For this reason, and of course because of the many heroes who kept appearing, it was imperative for her to build a dungeon here.
Okay, good idea. Then I can take a short breather. Okay, creatures, you're up. Dig tunnels, find dwarves, and pull out their beards. Reading my horde exploitation for experts handbook and came across something about a voodoo brew.
The voodoo brew was a shamanistic site for the horde. Little snots could make potions there that could be used much like spells.
Ah, and I only hear about this now? Damn, I could have used that thing 5 missions ago. It probably could have been used to corrode my way out of that damn cage. Come on, you little snots. Build a voodoo brew, slap some stuff together, and sell it as an energy drink. Get them! wipe them out, wash their faces with soap, paint fake mustaches on them.
A new area of the dungeon has been discovered. Ding dong! It's payday! Enemies have entered the dungeon. The first horde potion bubbled happily away, waiting to be used by the potion-throwing evil. Storm roared over the mountains. Whether heroes or creatures, they were all massively hindered by the strong winds. Perhaps this artifact the Dwarf Queen had spoken of really did exist.
Pretty damn coincidental that this artifact should be located somewhere around here, right where we need it.
Indeed, but the writers of this series have never been known for their excessive creativity.
True enough. Good for us, at any rate. If that thing is anywhere here to be found, I won't let a single little snot rest until it is dug up. I will, however, allow myself a little break in the meantime. The storm passed and lost strength. Now was a good time to hit the overworld to earn some evilness there.
What now? But I just made myself a cocoa with unicorn marshmallows. Absolutely true! That's what I thought.
Forward, creatures! Out into the cold with you! Pillage, plunder, move trail markers!
Ding dong! It's payday! Storm was soon brewing. Without the protection of an artifact, the Shivering Evil's creatures were sure to find it uncomfortable out there. The voodoo brew had been built. Little Snots could now brew wonderful potions at an alchemist's cauldron there.
Ah!
Once again, a thunderous storm hit the mountains. Payday. Your little snots have dug up a spider. One of your creatures has bit the dust. The storm had lost its strength. The healing evil had poured a healing potion on its creatures to wash away their bruises and boo-boos.
Oh, isn't that nice?
You've dug into a spider room. Enemies are in the dungeon.
payday.
Another storm was brewing. A hero fell victim to the icy storm. The slowly stalking evil seemed to have already come very close to the dwarven artifact. Very close indeed. The desirous evil's little snots had found an artifact in the underground. Once placed in a vault of evilness, it would unleash its power.
Oh, wonderful. Once again, I did an excellent job.
Move it, you lazy creatures.
Bring the artifact to the vault of evilness so that this freezing storm can no longer harm us.
The storm abated and moved on. Onrushing evil had applied horde speed to its creatures so that they could run and attack the enemy even faster or escape more quickly, whichever was needed. The complex evil now had access to complex potions. From now on, little snots could also make these at random in the voodoo brew. The researching evil now had access to basic potions. From now on, little snots would occasionally produce them too. defend the dungeon heart. It's payday. Optimizing Evil used Improved Dungeon to massively increase the efficiency of one of its units. Once again, a thunderous storm hit the mountains. Last Happy Evil's creatures had discovered a wagon full of dynamite. This could be used to clear weak rock formations out of the way.
Aha! Great! If Tristan was still here, I could tie him to the wagon, and then... explosions are fun just the way they are. Come on, let's blow something up!
The rock there looked a little porous. Some dynamite could probably get it out of the way.
Hey,
the storm had lost its strength.
It's payday.
Enemies are in the dungeon.
Your throne room is under attack.
Gold vein is nearly exhausted. Manivores have been discovered in your dungeon.
Ah!
another storm was brewing.
Payday.
The storm took its deadly toll among the heroes as well. A gold vein has been mined out. Enemies are in the dungeon. The boom screaming evil had used the explosive potion, making for an effect-filled blast. This could not only harm enemies, but also set fire to easily flammable things, an explosive mix. The dungeon heart is being attacked. The storm abated and moved on. Talia and the exploratory evil had discovered a new entrance on the overworld. This would give them access to a previously inaccessible area of the underground.
Oh, good. We're finally approaching the top of this damn mountain. Go, creatures! Smoke out the last few dwarves! Flatten them! Steal their wall decorations!
a new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. Payday! One of your creatures has bit the dust. Your demonic portal is under attack. The excavating evil had found a new passage to the surface. Even though the dungeon was completely flat, this still led to a much higher position on the face of the mountain. In keeping with this, as if some invisible line set by level designers had been crossed, the storm outside intensified. It seemed like the raging winds would last even longer from now on. Once again, a thunderous storm hit the mountains.
Oi, gods! Surely you're not going to let the vermin take away our good dynamite now, are ya? Come on, you nuggets! Get outside and guard that stuff!
The storm cost a hero his life. A new area has been unearthed in the dungeon. Thank you.
another rock formation I can blast away with dynamite, right? Great. Finally, something is happening around here.
The storm had lost its strength. The fetid evil had used the poison potion, releasing toxic and highly flammable fog into the dungeon. Doesn't that sound like fun?
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
One of your creatures has died. Your gold vein is nearly exhausted. Enemies have entered the dungeon. Another storm was brewing. The storm took its deadly toll among the heroes as well. Your army has just decreased in size due to death. A gold vein has been mined out.
Into the underground. Excellent! I bet it will take us all the way to the peak. All right, creatures, take that thing and wipe out all the guards.
The storm abated and moved on. Ding dong, it's payday.
Enemies have entered the dungeon.
Climbing evil's creatures have now almost reached the top of the mountain through another exit from the dungeon. The Council of Little Snots was almost within reach. A new area of the dungeon has been discovered. A gold vein is almost exhausted. A gold vein has been mined out.
you punks! It's about time I personally introduced you to my fists! This one is hefty, and this one is righty, and they both smell like doom.
That's for sure. They haven't seen a bathtub in a while, have they? Never mind the rest of what they're attached to.
I like your sense of humor, little black pointy ear. I'll try to kill you last! Die!
Once again, a thunderous storm hit the mountains. A gold vein has been mined out. The gym rat evil had used horde strength. This would allow its creatures to hit even harder. Your little snots have completely mined out a gold vein.
Inconvenient, I doubt. We'll postpone our little brawl until later, you maggots!
Brynhild, Queen of the Dwarves, had made her escape. Apparently, the battle had not gone quite to her liking.
Coward! Come back here! Huh. Just runs away from a fair man-to-man fight. And by man-to-man, I mean dwarf against an army of vicious, murderous creatures. Treachery!
The glamorous evil had discovered...
Finally, I've reached the thrice-damned mountaintop. But next time, I'll have my creatures build a cable car instead of climbing something like this again.
Of course, you could always try to quit smoking and drinking and do more for your fitness. Just a suggestion. Personally, it helped me a lot. And now that I'm training for marathons, I'm...
Yeah. Thanks so much for your little prep talk. Could you please write your well-intentioned advice on a piece of paper so I can make a paper aeroplane out of it?
Ungrateful wretch. Be that as it may, Tanya had actually made it to the top. There, however, all that awaited her was an inconspicuous stone gate.
That's less than impressive. Can't it glow or something? Is the battery dead? Maybe I should smack it with the flat of my hand.
Tanya was obviously intellectually out of her depth, trying to decipher this riddle. All she had to do was utter the secret formula. Flattery Dutch.
Flattery Dutch.
Flattery Dirk.
Flattery Dutch?
Well, that didn't work.
That didn't... very funny, hilarious. They should give you your own TV show for your jokes, you comedian.
Yes, thank you. I am waiting for offers. My agent will get in touch. In the meantime, you might want to just press that little button on the side so we can finally get back to business.
Stupid button. Stupid narrator. Stupid council of little snots.
Talia had finally reached the venerable Council of Little Snots, high upon Mount Snotmore. These wisest of the wise gathered together, and Talia asked them the most pressing question weighing on her mind. Would she herself one day sit on a throne as a ruler? Would she hold the strings of power in a fifth installment of the Dungeon series? Would the overpaid narrator finally shut his mouth? Wait a minute! Talia's stupid question simply bounced off the wise little snots. The most important question in the room, and for this story, was that of a new vessel for the absolute evil. The wise little snots deliberated when they finally stepped in front of Talia again, who still hung on to her naive dreams, mumbling, and unlike me has only been with us for two installments, the leader of the little snots held a bundle in its hands. Inside this bundle was a cute, cuddly, never-before-seen baby little snot. It's crazy the ideas they keep coming up with. The little snot named Gorgu had to absorb the essence of absolute evil in order to serve as an adequate substitute. But apparently the little diaper butt was not yet strong enough to absorb all of the required essence. Talia would first have to train and strengthen Gorgu before he could fully absorb the power of the absolute evil. The Big Eaty. Talia had caught the young Gorgu's favor. With a little more power, he could quickly become the new absolute evil. But to do so, he would need to be strengthened. The